Is it transmitting already?
It is. All right. Good morning, everyone. Today, the 24th of September, is a national day of prayer and fasting for healing for our country. So right after Mass today, we will expose the Blessed Sacrament. Our church is going to be open all day for adoration, for prayer, and 3 o'clock will be the rosary, and then we will have benediction and reposition of the Blessed Sacrament at 7 o'clock tonight. So let's begin our Mass this morning in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that, by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. Vanity of vanities, says Koheleth, vanity of vanities, all things are vanity. What profit has man from all the labor which he toils under the sun? One generation passes and another comes, but the world stays forever. The sun rises and the sun goes down, then it presses on to the place where it rises. Going now toward the south, then toward the north, the wind turns again and again, resuming its rounds. All rivers go to the sea, yet never does the sea become full. To the place where they go, the rivers keep on going. All speech is labor. There is nothing one can say. The eye is not satisfied with seeing, nor is the ear satisfied with hearing. What has been, that will be. What has been done, that will be done. Nothing is new under the sun. Even the thing which we say, see, this is new, has already existed in the ages that preceded us. There is no remembrance of the men of old, nor those who will come, nor those to come, will there be any remembrance among those who come after them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
You turn back to us, saying, remember, O children of men, for 1,000 years in your sight are as yesterday. Now that it is past, now that it is past, or as a watch of the night. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. You made an end of them in your sleep. The next morning they are like the changing grass, which at dawn springs up anew, but by evening wilts and fades. In every age, O Return, O Lord, how long? Have pity on your servants. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. Fill us at daybreak with your kindness, that we may shout for joy and gladness all our days. Prosper the work of our hands for us. Prosper the work of our hands. In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
I am the way and the truth and the life, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except through me. Alleluia, alleluia.
Continue to recognize and ask the Lord to be our refuge. When we focus on the divide, when we focus on issues that tear us apart, we can start to lose hope. Right? When we look at all of the loss of life, we can start to think, as we are into this so many months, will there ever be a time where we can go back to normal? Every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. Just invite him to be our refuge today and always, so that we can have hope, that we can recognize that all the things that can distract us, all the things of vanity of our world today can distract us from where the Lord really wants us to be. And that is being held in his loving embrace, which is our refuge, which is that place that will continue to provide
Let's now offer our prayers in the form of petitions to our loving God. Let us pray for the church throughout the world, that Christians everywhere can go to you, O Lord, for refuge, for hope, for strength, in the midst of all of the division. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray that Christians will be that source of unity so desperately needed in our society today. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our Pope Francis, for Archbishop Lucas, for all who hold and teach the Catholic faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. We pray today, we are celebrating Catholic education in our archdiocese. We'll be honoring several outstanding educators, one of which is our principal at Sacred Heart School, who is being honored tonight, as well as a teacher from All Saints. For them and for all of the educators in our archdiocese where Catholic education is so important and prevalent, especially in our Q schools, striving to offer a faith-based education in the midst of the most poor of the poor of our city. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for all of those who are suffering loss because of this coronavirus. For all those souls faithfully departed, and for the families who still mourn their loss, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in this this time that we can continue to raise up servants who will continually strive to help people realize that the Lord is our refuge in every age. So let's pray for vocations to the priesthood and religious life. Pray for Thomas, Paul, Patrick, Luke, Min, Ryan, Andrew, Trevor, Christian, Jacob, Pat, and Seamus. And for vocations from our beloved Sacred Heart Parish, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Today we pray, the special intention is for God's mercy on our nation and for the healing of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Almighty God, we ask you to hear all these prayers and bring before you with faith and confidence through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, which earth is given in human hands of man. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord,
accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church. Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offering. offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him with great goodness you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on a journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, to the resurrection, until you come again. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on a cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, and George, our Archbishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. Amen. At the same Savior's command and for my divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom and the power of the Lord, is now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us
mercy. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this time receive you sacramentally, please come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you now as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
right after Mass, I will be doing the exposition of our Blessed Sacrament. Again, then I will be having to leave right away. Go.com, I believe, is the website. Or listen throughout the state of Nebraska on their different stations. So KBSS this morning for their Carathon. So the Lord before are served with love, the suffering are comforted, and your people are strengthened by the sacraments. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. So please just bear with us and we will get ready for exposition.
O Jesus, we adore you, who in your love divine conceal your mighty Godhead in forms of bread and wine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O Jesus, we adore you, our victim and our whose precious blood and body become our sacred feast. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O come all you who labor in sorrow and in pain, come eat this bread from heaven, your peace and strength regain. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving